All righty. Okay. First timers, welcome, welcome. So Angles is looking at how our body functions, right? Like we walk, we run, we build every exercise and with weight and resistance to mimic those functions. So instead of you like kind of squatting up and down and doing presses and like working with your feet in like an even position, everything we do is going to be in like our what we call gait stance. So when you run and when you walk, one foot is touching the ground at a time, right? And we go through these different phases we walk through. We're going to be replicating all that stuff. So there's a lot of balance involved. And when we go to be moving and balancing, you're going to be focusing on the inside of your foot. So think gripping the ground with your big toe. Holding tension here, you might feel like a burning sensation in the bottom of the foot, and that's because the muscles are a little bit deconditioned. So they're not really used to it, right? And when you do that, you'll feel the muscles of your inner thigh really activate. That's how we get to our pelvic floor naturally. So think pelvic floor training is a much more functional, everyday using thing based off of how we walk rather than just like squeezing from the pelvic floor. What else? Our workout area. We have the six squares here. So think each square is going to dictate where we reach and where we press. So if this is, for example, the top left corner, top right, middle left, middle right, and then back left, back right. We're going to be using this as like a guide. So say like we're standing here and we're gonna reach over top of that rear corner, letting the hip open and things like that. Throughout the workout, we're gonna be going through these like pelvic positions, right? So we're changing how we can control our body while we connect into the ground, keeping the muscles active as we go through all these different pelvic positions. We'll go through the basic ones in the warm-up, and then we'll build off of all of that. All right. And then the effects that you get from it, we really open up the chest. There's a lot less tension in the shoulders and the chest. Your posture is going to feel a little bit more upright. Your hips will be very open. Your glutes will be nice and sore and all that good stuff. All right. Cool. Let's stand it up. What'd you say? Did you get sore from Tuesday?
Yeah.
Yeah, Tuesday? Yeah, Tuesday was hard. All right, so we got our right heel back. That heel is going to be raised up. We're stretching into our big toe. We're feeling that. Our left knee is slightly bent. This is our general gait stance. Take your hands here. I want you to open your chest up, lean back, stretch the stomach, stretch the chest. And then from there, you're going to fold down to your left leg. Stretch your left hamstring. Push yourself up, lean back, eyes up, reach the fingers apart, stretch the chest. Exhale, fold. Bend the left knee. Inhale, lift out of it, lean back, pull the arms apart, and fold. Last one. That's it. From here, we reach the right hand up. I reach my left arm through. I push the hip to the right. And then I bring it back. I push, big reach, lengthening that whole right side. Last three, big reach. Two. And last one. That's it. Now, scoot this left foot out wider. Right heel still raised. The hips are in the, like your feet are wide, your hips are in the middle of it. We dive into our left leg. We open up the left side of the body. That's it. We push from that left foot. Get up nice and tall. Reach to the ceiling and dive back left. Stretch the left glute. Push out of it. Big reach high. And load left. Inhale up. And exhale down. Last one. Now lean into your left leg, reach your arms out forward, push through the left foot, rotate the hands around. That's it. Dive back into the left leg, push, and dive. push, and dive, push, and dive. That's it. We got 3, 2, and 1. Hold here. Rotate left, bring it back, clap. Rotate left, bring it back, clap. So notice how that hip rotates. We stretch the glute. Yep, let the eyes follow. Last 2 and last 1. Awesome. Switching feet. So we're here to start. The first one, we fold over top of that right leg. I stretch the hamstring. And we lean back. I open up the chest. I push the hip forward nice and tall. And then I exhale, fold back down. Inhale, lift it. And exhale down. Inhale, lift it. Last one. And then hands are at the shoulders. We push the hip to the left. I reach that left hand up. I reach my right hand through. And I come back. I push and reach all the way up to the ceiling and get there. Really shift the hip over as much as you can to get right into this top oblique. Last 3, 2. And last 1. That's it. Cool. From there, we step wide. The left heel stays up. We stretch into the right butt. I press out of it. Lean up to the ceiling. Stretch the stomach. Exhale. Dive back into that right glute. Push out of it. You should feel a real big stretch in the outside of your right butt. Inhale up to the ceiling, last 1. That's it. Load to the right leg, arms are out in front. Push through, rotate left. Dive, drop, push. Keep the left heel raised. So moving through that right glute that whole time. That's it, so the pelvis turns open. Good. We got 2 and 1. That's it. Then we're low in the right leg. Rotate. Rotate. Try to get your hip to rotate to the right as you take the eyes around to follow that right hand. We got 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. All right, you're going to put ankle weights on. And then we're gonna start from the ground. So the ankle weights, make sure that you undo the Velcro first. And then you wrap it up. Cool, we're gonna start on the ground for our first series. First, our knees are gonna be together. We're gonna push our hips forward so we're here. So driving the hips forward so you feel this lower ab engagement. Right leg kicks out and reaches. Tap the knee in, kick and reach. Good, push the hip low. We got 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, right foot opens and kicks. Close it in. Open and kick. Push the hip lower. Stay low so you're feeling that lower abdominal fully engaged. Rotate open. So look, you want it to look like a plank position, right? We're just on the knee. So we're here. Last two. And last one. Cool, child's pose it out. Back in, left leg. So look, hips forward, active, reach, tap, reach, tap. We got four, three, two, one. Now we rotate open, kick and pull. Try to turn the foot to the left. Feel yourself press through that left hand a little bit more. We got four, three, two, one. Child's pose it out. We're going wide feet. We're here nice and tall. That right knee is gonna come into that middle right square. The left foot's in the left square. So see how my knee is wider than my hip and my foot is wider than my hip. Turn your fingers out just slightly. We're here. We press through that left foot to pull this knee in up towards the elbow. I tap down, release. I push and release. That's it. Try to keep the shoulders right over top of the wrists. We got five more. Last two. Last one. From here, we reach this right hand out. We hover. Bring it back in. Reach it out. Get long through the stomach, pressing through that left hand. Let that right shoulder rotate open. Two. Last one, put the right hand in front or a little bit more ahead of that left hand. So the left hand's underneath the shoulder, right hand's out in front. We press through that left toe, I'm hovering, and I kick from here. That's it. Keep the knee wide. We got six, five, four, three, two, one, right foot steps forward. We come up onto the fingers on this left side. My right hand comes back. I rotate. Now check to see where your weight is. Are you bailing to the outside or are you keeping the weight on the inside of the foot as you rotate? Grip the ground with the toe, lift yourself up, find the balance. Yep. Control through the inside of the foot. Tap back. Drive. Pull it in. Control it. Tap. Control and lift. Ooh. Good. We got five. Four. Three, two, last one. From here, tap, push the hip forward, pull it back. Tap, push the hip forward, pull it back. Good. We got four. Three, two, and last one. Nice, drop it back down. All right, right foot is in that right rear corner and left knee is real wide. So this is where we want the hips in between the 2 feet. The left knee is out wider than we are. We got our fingers turned out slightly. We press and pull. And I tap down, press and pull, tap, Push through that right foot. Keep the left knee wide. Raise the hip. That's it. Pressing through that left hand. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold it. Left hand takes the reach. Stretch through the stomach. Pull it in. We got 3, 2. Does it feel different from one side to the other when you do this? It's kind of wild, right? All right, then we got the left hand slightly in front. So think like back of the hand is even with the fingers on the right side. We grip the ground with that right foot. We keep the left leg wide. I pull it in and tap out. We got 6, 5. Foot is as high as the hip. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. All right. We got that left foot coming up.
What was that? That one is. You want both on? Or are you getting hot?
All right. So check in. Pull that left elbow back. Get the shoulder to rotate. Touching with the hands, grip the inside of the foot. Pull, get tall. Get this right shoulder back, hand is up. Control back in. Big lift. Find the control. That's it. Get deep into it. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, and last 1. Push the hip forward through the left leg. Make sure the left foot's square. We reach that right toe out. Pull it in. Tap. Pull it in. Four. Three. Two. And one. Nice work. All right, shake it out. Cool, grab some water, and we're gonna start with our heavier weight first. All right, we got our left foot forward. Our right heel is back. So think like right toe is even with your left heel. We're gonna have the weight right here with both hands. Both knees are gonna stay slightly unlocked. We dip the hips back. We sit into that left leg. Cool. Then I drive up and I press to the left. That's it. Drop it back. Pause. Big reach. Control that motion, pause at the bottom. We got 6, 5, 4. Eyes up, posture tall. 2, and last 1. Weight comes by the side, right heel raises. That's it. We shoot this right knee, pull it in, try to touch, and then we step back to this rear corner. I lean back into my right foot. I tap back in. I push back. Tap it in. Push it back. That's it. We got 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. Last one. From here, we dip left, sit into that left butt. Now I push, I rotate towards this front right corner. Control in, push. Load through that left leg. We got 6. Inhale as you come up. Exhale as you release. 3, 2, last one. From here, we're holding this arm up overhead. Right foot taps to the midline. Right foot taps wide. Tap to the midline, tap wide. That's it. We got 6, 5, 4, 3. Good, last two. Using that left inner thigh and left glute to move the body. Last one. Nice. Drop the weight. Coming back down onto the ground. Left elbow comes down, right leg is out, right hand is supporting. We turn the hip up. We pull to this midline, or pull to the height of your hip, pull the knee in, kick it back. Pull it in, and kick it back. Try to stack the torso. Try to keep your left hip over top of your left knee. We got 3, 2, and 1. Then knee comes low, kicks wide, rotate. Come in, kick wide, rotate. Now look down as you come in, look up over the shoulder as you kick out. Rotate the eyes with the hip and the shoulder. We got 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, rotating up, and last one. Nice, child's pose it out. Nice work. In between, we're going knees on the ground, arms are gonna reach out. We go into that hip drive position again. From here, we control down. I rotate over my right shoulder. I stretch into my left chest, and I push up out of it. And I stay on that side. Good. And if you want a little bit more, we can go full plank position and dip. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Child's pose it out. Nice work. All right, we're gonna stand it up. We're gonna grab that weight again. And we got our right foot at the top of that middle square, our left foot at the back of that middle square. Weights are at the shoulders. Both heels are down to start. We dip. Be mindful of how different it feels from one side to the other. Rotate right arm over to that shoulder. Drop back down, sit. Push. That's it. We got 4, 3, last one. At the shoulders, knee comes in, We step and I push. I lean to that rear heel or that rear foot, but the heel stays raised. Left leg is long. You should feel that left glute fire up. Come back in, balance and hover. Use the glute. Push. Load. Push. Load. Push. Load. So your hip should translate to the left side and then come back right. Good. We got three. Two. One. From here, we hold, we dip to the right. And then I rotate open and press. Get nice and tall. Keep that left heel raised. Dip and press. Control through that right hip. That's it. Open that left hip up to the side. We got four. Three. Two. And last one. Good, we keep it up. Push. Come square. Open wide. Square. Wide. That's it. Three. Two. And one. Nice. Weight comes down. Right elbow comes down, left knee is out. First, we rotate the hip. I pull the knee in at hip height, and I kick out. Three. Two. One, then knee comes in, kicks out wide. Eyes come down as we pull in. Eyes look over the left shoulder as we kick out. Create that nice circular motion, not just through the leg, but through the whole body. That's it. We got five. Four. Three. Two, and one. Bring it down, knees are together, arms are out. We're here. We dip into that right chest, eyes look over my left shoulder, and I push it out. Dip, stretch right, and push. That's it. And if you feel cool there, you can go full plank position. We got six. Five, four, three, two, last one. Rest it out. Nice work. All right, we're going handballs next series. All right, so first we're going to cross our right leg over our left, get nice and low. We sit into the glute, I take my hands up, I pull this right leg, I'm neutral now, and I tap back low. I lift and pull, get taller. Tilt the pelvis, load. Lift, get tall. Pause at the top. Last two. Now we're here, we step this right foot back. I lean back, I stretch the stomach. Then I come in and I reach this left hand across the side here, which I load my left butt, pull it back, big reach. load. We got 4, 3. You want to finish here. This elbow's up. So I'm loaded in my left hamstring and left glute. Last one. Hands are by the knee. We rotate open. So we're building off of that last position. And I close it down. Point that right leg. If you want a little more, left arm will reach forward. Good, last two. Last one. Shake it out. In between, we're gonna flush that lactic acid out. We're just gonna be here, both heels are raised, pressing out real quick. Try to push on an angle with the weights. Stay on the toes the whole time. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, not bad. Left leg crosses over. We sit into the right butt. Tall posture. Come neutral, point the left foot, tap back. Pull. Tap back. Ah. Three more. Last one. All right. We reach. Right leg reaches through, left arm rows. Sit, let the right knee bend so you're loaded in the glute. Lift up out of it. Try to reach out in front of you. So like way more in front of the foot. That's it. The hip will shift to the right. Your shoulders stack. Left foot stays straight or left leg stays straight. Big stretch up at the top, last one. By the knees. Rotate open, point. Close it down. Rotate open and point. Close it down. If you want more, right hand reaches. Take your time. Reset if you need to. 3, 2. Last one. Oh, that was ugly. Nice work. All right, we're gonna flush it out. We got our left foot slightly forward, both heels are raised. Same thing that we just did, now with a stagger. So we're here, wide, keep the feet staggered like we were. Close it in, all right? Pop. Four, three, two, one. Switch sides. So we're here and here. Same thing. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Cool.
Drop the balls.
We're gonna come onto the ground. So, first, we're gonna plant our left foot onto the ground. Our right leg is gonna be raised. If throughout the exercise you feel strong here, you can move the leg to here. But first, you're gonna lift the shoulders up off the ground. Eyes are looking up, not forward, so we're here. Left arm goes back, don't let the shoulder touch, right arm goes out. And then I pull it back. I reach, and I pull it back. I reach, and I pull it back. Shoulders are up. We got two. Last one. Hands come behind us. Right leg reaches all the way out. I pull the knees in, both of them, lift the butt. Right leg reaches, pull and lift. Right leg reaches, pull and lift. We got five, four, three, two, and one. Plant that left foot into the ground. Right leg can step down or it can hover. Shoulders are back up. Right arm reaches out, left arm reaches to the side. Pull it back, eyes are up. Grip the ground with the inside of that left foot to create the abdominal connection through the glute. That's it, we got four, three, two, shoulders are up, last one. Rest it out, nice work. Alrighty, we're going right foot onto the ground, left leg can either be held raised or supported. And the first one that we got is our shoulders lifting, left arm reaching, right arm out to the side. Pull it back. Shoulders are up. Eyes are up, not forward. Four. Three. Two, and last one. Weights come behind us, shoulders and head rest. Knees come up, lift the butt, kick the left leg, keep the right leg tucked for abdominal tension. We got six. Five, four, three, two, and one. Right foot's down, last thing. Left elbow or left heel is on the right. Now we got our left arm going out, right arm's going up. Shoulders are up off the ground, eyes are up. Reach, last thing. Root into the ground to get your shoulders higher. We got four, three, two, one. Drop the balls. Take a little rest for a second. And we're gonna roll over. Your left foot's going to, oh, sorry, let me face this way. So left foot's going to be back here, right knee's here. You're going to pull the knee in just like we did during that warm up. And then we're going to make a very slow and controlled motion with our left hip. So we're going to lower the hip maybe like 1 to 3 inches or 4 inches, depending on the person, while keeping abdominal tension. So you're going to do that by keeping the right knee pulled in. And it's going to look like this. We dip and I pull. I dip and I pull. All right. It's kind of awesome and awful at the same time. Right knee's in, pull it in tight. Dip, reach forward, pull it back. Dip, reach forward, pull it back. Dip, reach forward, pull it back. We got 3, 2, last one. All right, fingers are out, knees on the ground, all the way out in front of us. Point that left leg, reach that right hand. Holding here, left leg reaches out, pull it in. Reach it out, pull it in. We got 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bring it down. Nice work. All right, left knee is down, right leg is out. So first, we're here. Now, it's weird because you got to pull the knee forward to dip the hip and bring it back to here. We got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, knee comes down, hands come out, stack the hip directly over the knee, make sure it doesn't sway. Weight goes in the right arm, reach, close. Reach the arms out in front of you so your hip has to shift forward. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Child's pose it out, take a rest. All right, we're gonna do one more weight series. You can grab your lighter dumbbell or your heavier dumbbell. It's gonna be a mixture of a full body, like one arm rotating press. We're also gonna do some leg stuff off that. All right, cool. All right, let's do it. First, raise the heels. Got the weight in the right side. We pull and dip to that left ankle. Left shoulders pulled back, tall posture, tall chest. That's it. Pull, get out of it. Heels up. Bam. Pull. Drop. Pull. Take your time in each position. Pull. Keep that right arm straight. Load the glute. Good, we got 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Come up to the shoulder. Left foot reaches, push it back just a little bit. Reach. Pull it back. Keep the left heel up that whole time. Load, press. Load, press. Load, press. That's it. Get that left arm back to load into the glute. We got four, three. Do you feel how it kind of targets right underneath the bottom of your butt? Two, last one. Hold here, heels up. Press, rotate left. Oh, come back, oh, this is awful. We got seven, six. Try to take the eyes to the left. Five, keep that left heel up. Four, three, two, last one. Ooh, shake it out. All right, opposite side. Left foot's back. Both heels are raised. We dip. Cool. Last two. At the shoulder, tap. Jesus. Okay. Bring it back. Press through the inside of that right foot. Let the knee come to the midline. Four, three, two, and one. We hold, rotate, look right, control it in. Four, three, two, last one. Awesome, bring it in. Do a little fold over stretch, stretch those calves out. All right, we got our little cash out cardio section. So the first move, heels are up, right foot comes forward, left foot goes back. We rotate here, come back. It's quick, quick and light and tall. All right, then after that, we're dipping into the hips where we touch. Here, heels are up. I think we can do that. We're here, drive, catch, drive, catch, drive, catch. So we're propelling and controlling through the right leg, right? Like, yes, the left foot touches the ground, but the load is staying on that right leg. And let's do it, let's walk through it real slow, real quick. So it'll look like this. We're here. I swing the hands and pull the knee up. And if we pull the knee out wide, you'll flow right through it and then just come right back down. Get this arm back because that's what's going to load you into your butt, right? So the arms are here to help you. They're here to carry your momentum. They're here to rotate the hips to help load the glute. 30 seconds there. And then third thing, that right foot's forward. Hands are up, pull, come back, all right? We're gonna keep the hands tall that whole time. So it's all from the hips, all right? Then we'll break off that, then we'll hit the 30 seconds of each on that left side. Cool? Hoorah. All right, first one's the easy one. Heels are up, pop it. Thank you. whatever foot is going forward is the foot that we're propelling off of in the next one. Five, four, three, two, one. Here. Drive. Catch. Drive. Catch. Get that left elbow back. Five, four, three, two, and one. Oh my God, it's awful. Here, pull, come back, rotate back. Pull, back, pull, back. Get the hip to rotate left. Stay tall in the hips, tall in the posture. Get the whole hip and foot to rotate left. Five, four, three, two, and one. All right, opposite side. You all ready? Left foot going forward, left arm's going back. Hit it. Left arm goes back when the left leg goes forward. Five, four, three, two, one. All right. We're here. Heels raised. Pop. Catch. Pop. Five, four, three, two, and one. Oh my gosh, that is hard. All right, here. Pull, catch, pull, catch. Get tall, push through the left butt. Four, three, two, one. Nice work. That one was kind of easy, I think. Ankle weights are coming off. We're going to stretch. Right leg crosses over the left, fold it over. Press into the inside of that left foot. Hang the head. Inhale and exhale. One more. Switch sides. Let the head hang. Come on up. Wide feet. Reach down in the center. Let the head hang. Reach all the way through. Big inhale, big exhale. Hands out in front, left leg goes back, right leg comes through. Get into that glute stretch. Lift the butt up off the ground, grab that left ankle. Walk it back. Downward dog, big inhale, big exhale. Left foot swings through. Grab that right ankle. Really pull that foot towards your butt. Push yourself back into a downward dog. Take an extra second to really lengthen that hamstring and calf. Knees come onto the ground. Push the feet wide. Roll it back. Find your deep sit. Reach forward. Tuck the head, one big breath. All the way up to the ceiling. Right foot comes forward. Lean back. Step it up, opposite leg. Nice work, y'all. All right, weights are going back. Your ankle weights are gonna come right over here and leave them with the Velcro on, facing upward, so it'll look like this.